Hello everyone from all over the world watching us. Today is a great day for all of us. The weather is sunny and beautiful in Istanbul. I say hello to you, a warm greeting from Istanbul, Turkey. Dear guests, dear panelists, dear speakers, thank you very much. I'm extremely delighted to welcome you at Think Sport Education Week event. We will present you Think's techno-entrepreneurial educational approach, highlighting the inspiration areas for other schools. I would like to introduce to you our speakers, Mutlu Şencan, our innovation coach, entrepreneur trainer, and diploma program coordinator, and Tolga Kahraman, IT program coordinator. As introductory remarks, I would like to point out that Think Technology and Humanity College is the first and leading applied technology K-12 school in Turkey. Based on its uniquely designed curriculum and e-learning platform, TIG has converted 21st century skills training to students academic curricula. In addition to Minister of Education in Turkey Anatolian High School curriculum, TIG offers a unique diploma program whereby the students gain digital age competencies and skills. TIG high school graduates have a 100% success rate. Let me remind you of the hashtag World Edu Week. You can send us your quotation, your questions, and you can also send your question through the chat mode. Now, I leave the floor to Mutlu Şencan.
Hello everyone. I'm extremely pleased to welcome you here at Think's World of Week of Education event. And I'm also very pleased to speak on behalf of Think about Think's techno-entrepreneurial program. I'm the innovation trainer at Think for the last 2 years, and I'm very proud of the program that we've been running for the last 2 years at Think. Firstly, I would like to point out that Think has a unique diploma program whereby the students gain digital age competencies and skills. And Think trains young people who to integrate technology into their education, social life, and career through their gaining of digital competencies and a spirit of entrepreneurship. This whole idea is based on our founder's vision, educational vision, which is based on the premise that the sky is the limit. Only the sky is the limit for the children of our country, hence the of the world. And the schools should enable the students to dream and realize their dreams and hence themselves. In order to actually make this vision more concrete, Think has the aim of endowing the students to be competitive in the job markets in the local and global arena in a completely volatile and uncertain environment. And this idea is this commitment actually is very much reflected in the curriculum design for Think's techno-entrepreneurial educational approach. The diploma program, which consists of technology and entrepreneurship, has three basic pillars. The students gain interpersonal skills, and cognitive skills. And this is tailored around a very well thought of curriculum. And certain premises where the whole program rests on. Firstly, we teach to think outside of the box by incorporating critical thinking, design thinking methods in our classes. Secondly, we help our students discover their technical talents by exposing them to the highest demand technology areas and skills and engaging them in applied project work. And also we expose our students to real life problems by bringing the students together with industry experts, mentors, and members of the investment community. And also we teach the students to be finishers by incorporating agile and resilient leadership, team management and project management methods in our classes. And also we promote our students to get in touch with and to be part of the real techno-entrepreneurial ecosystem by holding a yearly school-wide competition and further promoting the success of their projects. All in all, we teach not for the high grades, but for making a difference in our students' lives. And in turn, the students touch upon the lives of others by their projects. So they receive ample opportunity to develop themselves into socially responsible global citizens. How about the curriculum? What's the curriculum like? And the curriculum, technology curriculum, is based on the anticipation of future technology trends. And it consists of areas including blockchain, artificial intelligence, mobile application development, game design, electronic coding, industrial design, etc. And the students at each grade acquire a focused expertise on a different thematic technology subject. So this is the basic idea around the technology curriculum. And in regarding the entrepreneurship curriculum, what we do is we teach entrepreneurial mindset, emotional intelligence, empathy, design thinking, project management, team management, entrepreneurship life cycle, social entrepreneurship, entrepreneurial ecosystem, stakeholders dynamics, among all, where the students go through, based on the both technology and entrepreneurial curricula, the students go through a learning experience which can be summarized by these steps, which starts from learning technology trends to actually presenting to investors and sponsors their projects. And now I would like to leave the word to my colleague Tolga Karaman to talk about the success stories from real student experiences at Think.
Merhabalar, ben Tolga Karaman. Ben de Think'te ICT koordinatörü olarak çalışıyorum ve bugün burada olmaktan heyecan duyuyorum.
I'm extremely excited to be here today as Think's ICT coordinator.
Sizlerle bugün Think'te uyguladığımız Tekno Girişimcilik Programı sonrasında ortaya çıkan başarı hikayelerinden bazılarını derledim ve bunları paylaşacağım.
Today I will share with you some of the success stories which result from the Tekno Entrepreneurial Program we apply at Think. Think a few of those stories I will share with you.
Birinci hikayemiz Fahir. Fahir'in annesi diyabet hastası ve sürekli diyabet hastası olduğu için vücudunun belli bölgelerini delip kanındaki şekerini ölçmesi gerekiyor.
Fahir, the first story is our student Fahir, whose mother is a diabetes patient, and she had to actually she had to inject needles in order to measure the blood sugar. Every time she had to do that, and
bu acıyı annesinin yaşamaması için kandaki şeker oranını nefesten ölçen bir cihaz geliştirdi ve bu cihazı topluma mal etti.
And Fahir, because he wanted his mother to ease his mother's pain, he developed an apparatus measuring the blood sugar level from breath throughout the entire diabetic patient community, and actually he's far into making it a commercial success at the moment.
Yes, geliştirdiği cihaz %92 oranında doğru şeker değerini gösterdiği tespit edildi. Şu anda bu cihaz Acıbadem Kuluçka Merkezi'ni tamamlayarak artık deneme aşamasına geldi.
At this point in time, this apparatus, it has completed the pre-incubation program at an hospital chain's incubation center in Turkey, and 92% of the time the measurements are correct, and it is being at the stage of being further tested at the moment.
Ve aslında bu birçok diyabet hastasının çektiği bu acıyı dindireceğine inanıyoruz.
So it is going to ease the many of the diabetic patients' pain.
İkinci başarı hikayemiz yine Think'ten 3 öğrencinin ortaya çıkardığı bir mobil uygulama.
The second success story that we would like to talk about is a mobile application that is developed by 3 Think students.
Sizin 0 ile 5 kilometre arasındaki seyahatlerinizi en ekonomik, en güvenli ve en sağlıklı yoldan yapmanızı sağlayan bir micro mobility uygulaması geliştirdi öğrencilerimiz.
This application is a micro mobility application that aims at enabling the 0 to 5 kilometer commute in a faster, safer and more economical manner.
Şu anda İzmir Belediyesi ile yatırım görüşmeleri devam ediyor ve öğrencilerimiz bu projeyle İzmir'deki trafik sorununa çözüm olmayı umut ediyorlar.
And at this moment in time, the municipality of İzmir is about to invest in this project, and the students expect to be part of the solution of the traffic problem of İzmir by this project.
Ayrıca bu öğrencilerin aşırı çevreci olduklarını sizlerle paylaşabilirim.
And also I can tell you that these students are very environmentally conscious students.
Üçüncü başarı hikayemiz aslında bir mobil uygulama. Mustafa isimli öğrencimiz dünyada dinlenen bütün müzik türleriyle ilgili radyoları bir mobil uygulamada topladı ve bunu ücretsiz olarak Apple Store'da yayınladı.
The third story that we would like to talk about is from Mustafa, and it's a radio application. It's called Big Big Radio, and Mustafa is a ninth grade student, and he developed a radio application, published it in Apple Store. The application provides access to world radios through a simple interface.
Bu uygulama ile dünya radyoları arasından sizin müzik zevkinize göre önerileri görebilir, favorilerinize ekleyebilir ve arkadaşlarınızla istediğiniz radyo kanallarını paylaşabilirsiniz.
So you can through this application you can share with your friends or with your relatives the preferred channels, your preferred radio channels, preferred music, etc.
Şu anda bile binlerce indirmeye ulaştı.
Thousands of downloads have already taken place.
Dördüncü hikayemiz bir aslında sosyal sorumluluk etkinliği.
Our fourth story is a social responsibility project.
Teknoloji ve İnsan Kolejleri ekibi olarak öğrencilerimizle birlikte Habitat Derneği ve Microsoft Türkiye ile ortak bir hackathon düzenledik.
We organized a hackathon together with Microsoft Turkey Habitat Development and Governance Association in order to raise awareness to the impairment free life for the impaired people.
Türkiye'nin 8 farklı ilinden 200'e yakın liseli genci bir araya getirerek bu gençlerin engellilerin hayatını kolaylaştıracak teknoloji projeleri prototiplemelerini sağladık.
So we brought together more than 200 students from 8 different cities, and those students developed projects, more than 60 projects that about making the lives of the impaired people easier.
60'a yakın teknoloji projesi prototiplendi ve bu projeler 3 Aralık Dünya Engelliler Günü'nde engellilerin kullanımına açılarak onlara bağışlandı.
More than 60 prototypes have been developed, were developed during this period, and those were presented and donated to the impaired people's needs at the World Impaired People Day.
Beşinci başarı hikayemiz de yine bir sosyal sorumluluk projesi.
The fifth story we have is also a social responsibility project.
Burada da yine ortaokullu öğrencilerimizle birlikte çevremizdeki elektronik atıkları toplayarak bunların bakım ve onarımlarını yapıp bu bilgisayarları çalışır hale getirdik.
In this project with the mid school students, what we did was we brought together the discarded computer parts and discarded computers and made them work again.
Bu çalışır hale getirdiğimiz bilgisayarı köylerdeki dezavantajlı okullara ulaştırarak onların bilgisayarlı eğitim sınıflarına sahip olmasını sağladık.
And then we delivered these refunctioning computers to the village schools and then made it possible for those students to have access to computers and the computer rooms.
Geriye dönüştürdüğümüz 25 bilgisayar ile iki ayrı köy okuluna bilgisayar sınıfı kurduk ve önümüzdeki yılda bu projeyi yürütmeye devam edeceğiz.
So far we have donated 25 computers to the two village schools and then next year we will continue with this project.
Bir de 6. başarı hikayemiz var. Bu da aslında teknoloji ve insan kolejlerinde uyguladığımız bir teknogirişimcilik ekosistemi.
Our sixth success story is actually a techno in entrepreneurial ecosystem project at TINK.
Her yıl düzenli olarak okulumuzda bir girişimcilik yarışması yapıyoruz ve bu girişimcilik yarışması kapsamında öğrencilerimiz tematik sorunlara çözüm önerileri geliştirip bunları ilgili yatırımcılara karşı sunuyorlar.
Every year we organize an entrepreneurial competition, entrepreneurship competition, and the teams are composed of mixed level students, and then the teams develop solution ideas to thematic problems, and then develop prototypes, business models, and canvas, and present them to the investors and the jury.
Aslında bu sayede birçok 21. yüzyıl becerisini öğrencilerimiz kendi akranlarıyla keşfetmenin yolunu buluyorlar.
In this manner, through this competition and teamwork, the students have ample opportunity to actually apply the 20th century skills that they've gained through from various classes. And from peer and also exercise peer learning as well.
Aslında sizlerle paylaşabileceğim onlarca hikayem daha var. Ama vaktimiz kısıtlı olduğu için ben sadece bu başarı hikayelerini sizlerle paylaşıp değerledim. Beni dinlediğiniz için teşekkür ederim.
Actually there are tens of more stories to tell you about Things achievements, but of course our time is limited. So I really appreciate for having listened to the stories that I've told so far. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Amazing project. It's really impressive. Thank you, Mutlu Hoca and Koldi Hoca. Now I
thank you.
Start to our panel. Introduce our panelists. Zeynep Dereli, founder of TINK. Welcome, Zeynep Hanım.
Arzu Kasoy,
educational director at Teachers Academy Foundation. Welcome, Arzu Hanım.
Hello.
Mine Dedekoca, serial entrepreneur and startup mentor. Welcome to our panel. Thank you for being here with us.
Our panel question
will be based on teaching for the digital age in particular. Now I would like to ask Zeynep Hanım for our first question. Zeynep Hanım, can you teach entrepreneurship?
That's a brilliant question. First of all, let me first start by saying what an amazing honor it is for me to be here with you, with our esteemed panelists and with our esteemed team. When we started TINK, Technology and Humanity Colleges 4 years ago, it was a dream. And the dream was to try to find an educational model that would be applicable for the 21st century. And what we were thinking back then has been proven extremely true by COVID-19. As many of us have been discussing this, COVID-19 has been indeed the technology, chief technology officer for many different sectors, especially education. Because education has been the driver of economy, either directly or indirectly, for centuries. And what we were seeing back then, maybe 4 or 5 years ago, when we were thinking about the model for TING, was that education was lagging behind the digitalization of the other sectors. It was almost as if, you know, everybody was going at a much faster pace and educational institutions were trying to conserve their status quo. And yes, status quo and tradition are two very important things in education, but also you need to be up with the times. And why are we talking about entrepreneurship and entrepreneurial minded learning and teaching? Well, we're talking about them because it is indeed a proven model for helping students attain 21st century skill sets. What are those skill sets? They are the skill sets that our amazing teachers have discussed. And you've seen some of the results of this educational approach through the innovative projects of our students. It actually, so entrepreneurship is not necessarily something that can be taught, but entrepreneurial mindedness is indeed something that can be taught. So what we have focused our educational model here at TING is actually teaching entrepreneurial mindedness. And within that, we focus on three C's. The first one is curiosity. A lot of people, a lot of students have been actually complaining about the fact that education today indeed kind of kills curiosity because it's a prescribed model and we tell teachers, students, these are the things that you need to learn and don't think about anything else. Whereas through an entrepreneurial minded approach, you actually encourage students to be curious. You want them to think outside of the box. And these are indeed the foundations of the 21st century skill sets. So the first C is curiosity. The second one is connectivity. What do I mean by that connectivity? What I mean by it is you can actually think of a historical incident that happened and think of its concept and its context within the context of ballet, for example. What happened during that time? How did culture change historical facts, or how did politics change culture? And what are the things that are necessary to resolve some of the problems that we're facing today? Similar to what our student Fahir did with his mother's issue. She has diabetes like millions of people around the world. And he realized that his mother was experiencing difficulty because she had to poke herself through a needle in order to get her blood sugar levels. And he used his technology knowledge and his entrepreneurial mindedness to solve a problem that is existent throughout the world. And he used biology, chemistry, he brought together all of these different subjects in order to come up with a solution for a potential problem. So initially he was curious. Why? Because he saw that there was a problem and he looked at the different ways of resolving this problem. And then he brought together all of his knowledge and the knowledge that exists around the world. And then he was able to come up with a solution. And the last C that we focus on at TING for our entrepreneurial minded teaching is creation of value. This is something that I have almost based my whole life upon. Because right now in this world, a lot of people look at the world as almost like a profit making scheme. And education needs to focus on value creation rather than profit making. And educational institutions, be it private, be it public, and there is a lot of discussion around that too, they need to all look at value creation. And if we can install this ideology, this worldview in our students, I think we will end up living in a much better world. And hence, because of this approach that we've taken, you've seen that there are many numerous projects, civil society and social group projects that have come out of our educational model. And our students work on all of these projects in order to create value for the rest of society. And so in order to answer your question, Metin Bey, Metin Hocam, well, you cannot teach entrepreneurship, but you can indeed help students have an entrepreneurial mindset where they actually look at life as not a zero-sum game, but one that you bring value to one another, and you look at world in a much more positive way. For example, COVID-19, yes, it has been disastrous for many reasons, but it has also presented many opportunities. Opportunities such as this T4 event. I would like to thank Mr. Vikas Pota and all of the organizers for putting together such a global event whereby we're actually getting to learn from different best practices around the world. Only through sharing can we actually include and increase our knowledge and create value for our societies at large. Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you very much, Zeynep Hanım. It's amazing things, and I need to underline to what have you said, because it's very important. Thank you. Stay with us, please. Our next question addressed to Arzu Atasoy. Arzu Hanım, how can you teach entrepreneurship?
Well, thank you very much. First of all, I would like to say hello and happy World Teachers Day to all my colleagues who are watching us right now. And thank you very much for organizing this event. As an answer to your question, I think to be able to teach entrepreneurship or entrepreneurial mindset, first, we teachers need to adopt those skills as role models, as critical thinkers, creative thinkers, and interdisciplinary learning designers, I could say. Unless we have that capacity, it's not possible to design the desired learning ecosystems that introduce entrepreneurship to students during daily practices, because this is not a one-shot skill that or capacity that we can develop, but we have to have sustainable, consistent practices. So we should first reflect on our own skills as teachers, because empowering students' entrepreneurship requires, as I said before, consistent and coherent set of daily practices. And when we think of entrepreneurship, we can say it's a person's ability to turn ideas into action. So students need to be introduced to this arena through creative teaching approaches requiring critical thinking. And Zeynep Hanım also mentioned a couple of key terms like curiosity and critical thinking. That's what I would also ask or request my colleagues to think about and to try to practice in their teaching practices. In the class or in the school environment, we should aid students with a differentiated learning environment and high quality teaching. So I also would like to point out the pedagogical aspect of entrepreneurship or entrepreneurial skills, thinking skills as a mindset. Sometimes we have some prejudices, but we don't realize that we have those prejudices in terms of students' personality types. We mostly presume that entrepreneurs or children or youngsters who can be entrepreneurs are usually extroverted, and we usually focus on the extroverted students. And I could easily say, and I'm sure you would share my opinions, there are significant amount of introverted and very successful entrepreneurs, and I wonder how they would be, more successful if they were supported by their learning environments during their school time. So these kinds of students, all kinds of learning types of and personality types should be involved in this situation to help them. And we should understand how the introverted learners also process and produce different dimensions of entrepreneurship. This is also a very, very important thing for me, because inclusion, diversifying learning, but inclusion is very important. So we must think about all the capacity that we can include to our learning environments and nurture the potential of each student. Thank you.
Welcome. Thanks a lot for your good things about and main point that you instructed to us. And for sure, we'll ask some more questions if we manage our time. when we come to Q&A sessions. So, and Mina Hanım, the last question for this session for you. Why an entrepreneurial mindset?
First of all, I would like to thank you for inviting me to the panel. I'm thrilled to be part of this event. So it is really important that we are providing the entrepreneurship education to the students. So if we would be looking at the benefits of providing these students entrepreneurship education, we should be looking at two dimensions. So one is the personal development side, and the other one is the overall economic growth for the nation. So when we are talking about the personal development of the students, actually the entrepreneurship education is fostering the advanced skills of creativity, as Zeynep have mentioned, and innovative thinking, which empowers and inspires students to take initiatives, to take risky decisions, and also accept responsibility to thrive in the challenging world. So such students, we see that they develop the ability to recognize opportunities, and they think critically. And they not only think critically, but they also tend to solve problems creatively. And above all, they all learn to push their boundaries. So these skills of critical thinking, communication, collaboration, not only help them making them forward-thinking individuals, but also develop nimbleness in them to adapt to rapid changes. And it is also helping them shape their own careers along the way. So if we are talking about integrating entrepreneurship into the curriculum, which Think College is doing, it is actually making these students develop knowledge and skills and attitudes that impact their academic performance as well. So, and it is also developing their entrepreneurial competency at the end. It helps them to identify and hone their latent talents, and as well as act in a socially responsible way. So we were like listening to the examples that these students were working on. So we see that they are also building these social responsibility projects, which will be just like serving the community as well. So through these entrepreneurship classes, these students develop the skill to identify the potential audience, the target customers, and seek approval from the people and understand their needs, because we're talking about customer needs, customer pain, and learn how to sell their own ideas when they turn into business ideas. And they also learn the importance of doing research, because this is what we do in entrepreneurship. We do research about our business ideas, whether it's going to work or not. So it is also teaching them the importance of doing research and understanding the importance of learning from one's mistakes, because it's the most important thing in entrepreneurship. One of the most important things in entrepreneurship is learning from failure. And if we look at the overall impact it has on the economic growth of a nation, actually this education, entrepreneurial education, plays a significant role in the growth and development of a nation, and the economic growth of a nation is actually supported by entrepreneurial thinking skills and the entrepreneurial activities of its people. So actually they are driving the force which is fueling the economic growth in the overall sense. And so lastly, to sum up, I would say that the entrepreneurial innovations, along with the technological advancements and the global competitiveness, are really essential for a state, for a country to create new jobs, because we've been seeing the importance of creating new jobs, especially during this COVID period. And also aid in the economic growth of the country.
Thank you very much, Mina Hanım. Appreciate it for all of you that you mentioned and underlined for us. I think we have good time to go forward. Now it's time to Q&A session. We have already some questions from our audience. Let me remind you of the hashtag World a week. You can send us your question, and you can also send your question through the chat mode. And let me check the question. And first one, coming from Barış Bey, Zeynep Hanım, I would like to ask this question to you. What can we do to make the most out of ourselves if the school is prohibiting us just to study the cure?
So just to repeat the question, what can we do? What can we do to make the most out of ourselves if the school is prohibiting us just to study the courses, I suppose. I suppose that's just to study the courses. So what can we do? Well, the pandemic has taught us that we can do quite a lot, can't we? I don't know what you guys think, but if you can manage your own time and if you have self-discipline and self-motivation, then you can decide on the things that interest you. First of all, what we would what we would advise you to do is to try to figure out who you really are, rather than what everybody's telling you to be. So try to figure out the things that you're interested in, and be adventurous, and take risks. These risks can only be taken, well, they can be taken at later stage in life, but actually you're much safer and much better off trying to take these risks at a younger age. I'm sure Milanam and Arzanam will actually agree with me. So because when you're younger, when you don't have many other responsibilities than to develop your own personal skills, you can take quite a few risks. And these risks, you don't need to go through a one followed path. You need to create your own path in a way. And when we're talking about teachers, and I would like to congratulate everybody's World Teacher Day, and thank all the teachers around the world for the amazing work that they're doing, because without them, we really, none of us would be here. And what the teachers have become and what they're becoming almost is, rather than mentors, they're becoming coaches, because everybody needs to create their own pathways now. And mentorship is more about the things that the path that you walked on before. But the world is changing. There's this constant change. And in order to cope with the change, you need to learn to cope, to predict change. And that was one of the things that we wanted to help our students with. So first of all, you need to be open-minded. You need to be curious. You need to look at what's out there. And there are many different platforms. And within these platforms, there are many opportunities for free learning material. It's more about creating your own interests and understanding your own interests and looking at the opportunities that are available. And during the pandemic, most of the institutions have actually offered these courses free of charge. So you can actually take this moment and utilize it to further your self-interests rather than only the coursework. Yes, COVID-19 has indeed created some difficulties within education, but it has also presented certain opportunities for those students who want to develop their own interests and their own skill sets. Because you don't have to travel to school in most countries, you actually are saving time, and you have some time on your own hands, which you can actually use to learn about entrepreneurship, to learn about artistry, to learn about psychology, to learn about anything that you want to learn about. So please use this opportunity, this brief blip in time almost, to find out what you like so that you can pursue these goals and interests in higher education.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Zeynep Hanım. And also, Svetlana text something. Your speaker presentation will be provided. So we have already finished our speaker session. It was first 20 minutes. I'm sorry, you can maybe you can watch later on. And so Barış Bey had curriculum which is not enough for today's standards, which you already answered, Zeynep Hanım. What about your opinion?
I would like to add something on top of what Zeynep Hanım has been mentioning. So it is really important, as Zeynep Hanım mentioned, it is really important to discover what your passion is about and like what you're good at. But at the same time, it's also important to discover the things that you do not like doing. So, and this is like this period is like a test and trial period. So this is like ample time that has been given to you because of a crisis, because of COVID, that you can test and try what you can do, what you cannot do, and what works and what doesn't work. Because entrepreneurship, as I have already mentioned during my speech, that it is all about test and trial. So you have to test and see what is working and what is not working. So it is really a perfect time at this moment. This is what I tell the startups that I'm mentoring as well. This is perfect timing to fine tune what you are going to do or what you're planning to do. So use this time to test and try what you are planning to do, and if to see if you're really good at it or not, or if the business idea is really valid or not, to test with your customers and like the customer, target customers and the potential users.
Thank you very much. It's really good additions to our questions. And then Arzu Hanım, what about you? Can I take your opinion about that questions as well?
Sure. Thank you very much. Well, I think Barış Bey mentioned about the limitations, time limitations, and the exams that students have to take at the end of the year. That's why they, you know, have difficulties in introducing different practices in their classrooms, whether it's in person or on online, especially when in the last couple of months, online live sessions with students are difficult to have, and we're now trying to improve that. But I understand his perspective, first of all, I can say, yes, there is a curriculum that we have to follow. And it's a heavy curriculum when compared to the Turkish curriculum is heavy when compared to, is loaded when compared to other countries' curriculums. But let's consider a curriculum as a framework telling us what to do. And how to do that is our business, our expertise as teachers. So let's say critical thinking. How can I introduce critical thinking into my English classes, into my mathematics classes? Bringing a social issue to my mathematics class and asking kids to discuss, to create new alternative methodologies or practices that can be transferred also to the outer side of the class should be our thinking way. Because let's say the curriculum is a house. Someone gives you a house, but how to decorate that house, what color of sofa you'll buy, what type of television you will buy for that house is up to you. It's up to our perspective, how we can bring all together and also within that time frame. And I think there is a limitation that we as teachers put ourselves into, considering that the class times are the only times that learning is possible. So how about, for example, during these times, how about introducing an opinion or an item of the curriculum to the students online, and then giving them opportunities for collaboration, giving them projects or asking them to design their own projects on that issue, and then bringing out the environment so that they can present their opinions to each other, discuss, collaborate again, and create something new. It has a lot of advantages. And as teachers, we say we're getting tired a lot in front of the screen or in the classroom. We show a lot of physical effort as well. But when students are active, when students are introduced into a diversified collection of methodologies and interdisciplinary higher level thinking skills, then it will be easier for us to introduce such topics. So actually, I think the curriculum is not the limit. It's the way we think about the curriculum is the limit. Thank you.
Well, welcome. Thank you very much. New question is also like big question. Maybe you can see in your screen, and I would like to pass this question to Zeynep Hanım. Zeynep Hanım, can you see the question on the screen?
Unfortunately, it's too small for me to read.
Yeah, okay. Let me read for you. Onur Ünver, first congratulations. Great to listen to you all. I am curious about how teachers serve the needs of students in an interdisciplinary way, thinking about the example of the blood sugar measurement tool. When can the students work on that? Clubs, classes, and how do students get mentorship when they have an idea that spans broad range of disciplines? Can you explain more about interdisciplinary processes and mentorship in the school? Thank you.
Well, thank you very much for the congratulatory note. Actually, if we can go back to our teachers, Mutlu Hoca and Tolga Hoca, I don't know if it would be possible because this question touches upon what they were discussing. Can we do that?
Yeah, Mutlu Hocam, Tolga Hocam.
Mutlu Hocam, how do you provide the mentorship to our students? Could you discuss
sure.
that because you're the
sure.
leader.
Actually, mentorship is about, starts from, let me put it this way. We start with the entrepreneurship life cycle by highlighting the need generation. So identifying a need and developing that need into a solution proposal. And then working on that solution proposal, both from a prototyping perspective and from a business model perspective. Mentorship is actually throughout all these stages. How do you identify a need? How do you assess your idea? How do you validate your idea? What kind of actions do you need to take in order to touch base with your potential users, for example? So throughout the life cycle, we provide guidance to the students, and also we bring into the picture more industry experts, mentors who are also industry experts to actually give them a flavor of real world developments in that sector, in that particular sector. For which their solutions fit. And also the second aspect is the collaboration between the technology curriculum and our curriculum, entrepreneurship. So we do the projects jointly, and then we base our development of project development part on the basis of their technology skill sets that particular class receives at that particular moment, for example. For example, last year, one of the projects was artificial intelligence for Anatolia, yes. where Tolga Hocam was the idea generator. And maybe he wants to say a couple of words for that. And then I...
Okay.
AI for Anatolia'da nasıl birlikte çalıştık hocam?
Geçen yıl şimdi bir girişimin başlayabilmesi için aslında biz hep şuna inanıyoruz Mutlu Hocam'la birlikte. Öğrencilerin öncelikle gerçek bir problemin farkına varmaları gerekiyor. Biz de bu problem gerçek problemi çocukları kavuşturabilmek için farklı senaryolar yaratıyoruz. Mesela AI for Anatolia diye bir proje başlattık. Bu proje kapsamında çıktık öğrencilerle birlikte günübirlik Adana'ya gittik. Adana'da çiftçilerimizle bir araya gelip onlara hem gönüllü teknoloji eğitimleri verdik hem de onların sorunlarını dinledik.
For example, AI for Anatolia, that project involved actually bringing the students to the real farmers, the world of the farmers, and then listening to their needs and then applying an AI solution to their needs, developing a project as such, and then projects as such. And those projects were also part of the yearly competition, entrepreneurship competition that we had. So this is the kind of collaboration between the techno part and the entrepreneurial part at Think at the moment.
Bir başka örnek daha verebilirim. Anadolu'da mesela genelde şöyle bir deyim vardır. İşte yeni teknolojiler meslekleri elimizden alıyor, mesleklerimizi kaybedeceğiz diye bir kaygı var. Tüm dünyada bu kaygı yaşanıyor.
Yeah, there is a general concern that the high tech practices will take away our jobs.
Bir öğrencimiz sanal gerçeklik gözlüğünü kullanarak bizim mesela Anadolu'da olan tematik meslekleri işte çömlekçilik gibi ya da işte halı dokumacılığı gibi bu meslekleri kayıt altına alarak korumaya alma fikrini geliştirdi.
For example, one of our students has developed the has worked on the idea to actually record the professions, the artisanal practices in Anatolia by using enhanced reality glasses and enhanced reality technology.
Yıllar sonra mesela bu korumaya alınan meslekleri bir kişi VR gözlük takarak o mesleğin nasıl yapıldığını izleyip öğrenebilecek. Şu an bunun için farklı yatırımcılarla görüşüyoruz.
So now this project is at the stage of talking with the investors. But to wrap up this the question in terms of mentorship, we actually coach the students at every stage of the entrepreneurial life cycle by bringing them together with the relevant industry experts and tools and techniques and technologies.
Thank you very much. It's great impact. Thank you, Tolga Hoca, Mutlu Hoca. You put lots of effort to that main point. And then every good things has an end. We have 8 minutes left. And then I would like to point out our 5 key steps that another school should take to replicate this school's expertise, that which is very important. The first one is space, future technological trends and requirements. Second, an innovation entrepreneurship curriculum that guides the students to transform their creative ideas into entrepreneurial projects. And number 3, a wide spectrum of class and activity offering that appeals to the students' technological interest. And 4, team corporate partnership program for mentorship and internship opportunities. And 5, a techno-entrepreneurial curriculum that stresses social innovation projects and social impact. At this point, I would like to take your last word, and I would like to start with Arzu Hanım, and then Mine Hanım, and we will go.
Well, thank you very much for this organization and congratulations on your great work. It really sets an example to many other parties. And considering schools that do not have the same opportunities, maybe we could add it's the mindset that we can initiate everything with. No matter what you have, what resources you can have a lot of resources, you can have limited resources or no resources at all, but you can begin from somewhere and try to expand it. So exposure and access is highly important in this issue, I think. And we are always very open for collaboration. Thank you for the Think team for these great efforts and results. Congratulations, and I also would like to thank Mr. Vikas Pota and the T4 World Education Week team for all this organization, bringing hundreds of thousands of teachers all together, united in one mission for sharing good practices, learning from each other on this special week of World Teachers Day. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And Mine Hanım, it's your turn.
So as final words, I would like to thank again to you for inviting me. And adding on top of what Arzan has mentioned, it is really important. It's not about your resources. It's not about what you have in terms of either like the curriculum, the infrastructure and thing. It's all about the mindset. So it's really important that we create this entrepreneurial mindset in our students. And so encourage them to think about thinking about solutions to the problems that they have in their community, in their households, in their minds. So to look at the problems that they have, for example, when they're eating ice cream, if it is spilling, to find a solution like a cone, maybe like a solution for onset stealing. So it should be the approach that the students are taking towards life. It's not something that they have that they are studying in school, but it needs to be the approach that they take towards life. So that would be one thing that I would encourage the teachers and the schools to apply to their curriculum and their study methods. And I will also like to thank for putting together this event together. We always say that sometimes crises create these opportunities, and this is a huge opportunity bringing together all schools from all around the world, exchanging their ideas, exchanging their experiences. I think this was really an invaluable opportunity for all the schools, for all the attendees listening to these real life experiences.
Thank you. Zeynep Hanım, screen is yours.
First of all, thank you for everyone. Thank you to Vikas Pota and the T4 World Education Week team. Thank you Arzu Hanım, thank you Mine Hanım, Metin Hoca, Mutlu Hoca, Tolga Hoca, Oğuz Hoca, Gül Hoca, Hakkı Bey, everybody who's been involved and all the hard work that's gone into showcasing our educational model and also showcasing what Turkey is doing in education, not only at TINK, but through Arzu Hanım and Mine Hanım's experiences and their hard work. What they are saying, I couldn't agree with it more. It's all about the mindset. And if we are open to sharing, and it's an open, everything needs to be on the open platform, and it should be all about collaboration. Well, at TINK, we are totally ready to share all of our know-how, all of our knowledge, and all of our experiences with the rest of the world, anybody who wants to learn from it. And we would love to hear more and learn more through your experiences so we can all grow together globally. And thank you everyone for listening and for your wonderful questions.
Thank you, Zeynep Hanım. Mutlu Hocam and Tolga Hocam, your last words, please. Open your microphone, please.
The last 2 years has been a very exciting adventure for me, and it's still going on. To be part of this journey with TINK in the techno-entrepreneurial project. And I do totally agree that it's all about mindset and what we are after. And I have students at mid-school as well. And you should see them. I mean, 10-year-olds, 11-year-olds, the idea, the mindset that they develop into how they want to become on the solution side at any problem situation. So this is actually very rewarding for me, and I think this is a very good. I think TINK is on the good track here, right track, I should say.
Thank you, Tolga Hoca. Your last word, please.
Ben aslında hep öğretmenliği, özellikle Türkiye'deki öğretmenliği veya TINK'teki öğretmenliği bir koleksiyonculuk gibi görüyorum. Aslında bizim ülkemizde, elimizde, gençlerimiz arasında çok çok güzel değerli taşlar var. Bence biz bu değerli taşları doğru eğitim modeliyle doğru yerlere yerleştirdiğimizde her şey o kadar güzel ve heyecan verici oluyor ki. Bu motivasyon, bu inanç, çocukları bir yere getirebilme tutkusu sanırım bana bu mesleği sevdiren ve hiç durmadan çalışmama neden olan en büyük güdü diyebilirim. Her şey için teşekkür ederim.
Thank you. It is time to say last things, and then I am trying to finalize our event, and we will finish within 30 seconds. Thank you very much for your participation from all over the world. Thank you very much to our speakers and panelists. Big thanks to Vikas Pota and his great team. They really did very successful projects and events. And also my team, Oğuz Hoca, Gül Hoca, Hakkı Bey, Fatih Hocam. Thanks a lot for being with us and put your great effort to our projects. I would like all of us, I'd like you say goodbye and shake our hands. Everyone, please shake your hands. And Oğuz Hoca, now we can close our event. Thank you. Bye-bye.